Please be seated. Ina mana, ina reo, ina hoe fa. Tena koutou, tena koutou, tena koutou katoa. Vice Chancellor, Pro Chancellor, Council members, special guests, staff, graduands, family and friends of graduands. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of the University Council members and staff of the University. In particular, I welcome our guest speaker, Dr. Paul Reynolds. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week we will be conferring and awarding more than 7,000 qualifications on some 6,400 students, in person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 486 students will graduate in person and 150 students will graduate in absentia. I will be assisted by Mr. Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor. This is a happy and memorable occasion for you, the graduands, as well as your families and friends who have supported you during your studies. We congratulate you all. Equally, your achievement brings pleasure and satisfaction to the academic and professional staff of the university who have played their part in your success. I was going to say to you that the graduation procession today brought academic flavour and colour to the streets of Auckland. Well, sadly, the rain dealt to that and dampened things. However, in this part of the ceremony, you will experience the pomp and tradition benefiting your well-deserved day of celebration. Over a period of 130 years, the University of Auckland has become a comprehensive, research-led university with a strong international reputation. Today, there are more than 40,000 students and 5,000 staff. Moreover, we are New Zealand's largest research organisation, with one-third of the country's externally rated world-class researchers. Within New Zealand, only our university is ranked within the top 1% of the world's universities. We also have a strong commitment to Māori education. Of all the Māori degree graduates in New Zealand each year, 25% come from just one institution, the University of Auckland. We jealously guard our position amongst our competitor universities and are always looking to create new opportunities for all our undergraduate and postgraduate students. Last month, we confirmed the purchase of the 5.2 hectare former Lion Breweries site on Kuiper Pass. This purchase will provide the university with a site for expansion over the next 50 years, contiguous with the city and Grafton campuses, and with the major business area in Newmarket. We will occupy the first of these new facilities in November 2014. So as you graduate, please reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and consider the wide range of postgrad options available to you at Auckland. I ask you to consider that because we can never rest on our laurels, especially in a challenging and ever-changing world. Whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, in these hard times, we should be spending more on universities, not less. But that is enough of the substantial issues facing us all as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations. Because today is your day, the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I am delighted to welcome as our guest speaker, Dr. Paul Reynolds, Chief Executive at the Ministry for the Environment. Paul joined the Ministry as Chief Executive in July 2008. Prior to this, he was Chief Policy Advisor at the Ministry of Research, Science and Technology from 1998 to 2002, and then Deputy Director General of Policy at the Ministry of Agriculture and Forestry through to 2008. Before taking up his government appointments, Paul had a scientific research career. This began in 1985 with the then Department of Scientific and Industrial Research and continued through to 1992, after which he joined the Crown Research Institute, Hort Research. Paul holds a PhD in biochemistry from the University of Otago. In addition, Paul is currently chair of the Government's Leadership Development Centre. He is also chair of the advisory board to the Victoria University of Wellington School of Government. Please welcome with me Dr. Paul Reynolds.
Thank you for inviting me here to speak to you today and be part of the celebration of your achievements. Today, we mark the successful completion of your studies. I'm sure that for many of you, it will feel like it has been a long journey. However, you leave university not only with your qualifications, but also with untold strengths and resources inside you that will pave the way for your future careers. As science graduates, there's a world of opportunity available to you. Science is critical in all of the big challenges the world is facing, whether it's enhancing public health, advancing technology, or improving the quality of our environment. This world of opportunity means that a career in science isn't limited to one pathway. Looking back at my own career, I continue to use the skills and knowledge I first developed at university as the cornerstone for the work I do today. And whilst age and experience have shaped these skills and grown my knowledge base, the fundamentals remain. The core research skills that I built during my undergraduate and postgraduate studies are the same core skills that I have applied throughout my career. Analytical agility, defining problems and formulating questions, and developing the tactics to work effectively with others all continue to appear on my list of core skills. I tend to describe the first half of my career as being based on technical and scientific skills. However, as I look back, I see that during this time, I built the management and influencing skills that helped me to make the move into more senior leadership roles. There are a lot of comparisons between previous roles I've had leading research teams and the work I do now. As a program leader, I had to influence other scientists to join their research to the work that I was developing and to accept and have confidence in the calls that I was making on how that research progressed. In my current role as Secretary for the Environment, I lead something called the Natural Resources Sector. Here I have to influence other chief executives in central government so that we can collectively deliver better quality policy advice and outcomes for New Zealand that benefit both the economy and the environment. Many of the skills I now rely on are the ones I had to learn on the job. I can't stress enough the importance of building a full range of skills, both technical and what are often referred to as soft skills. Don't let the name fool you. These are the cluster of personal qualities, habits, attitudes, and social graces that make someone a good employee. Whether you're applying for a generalist position, like a policy analyst, or a technical job, like a research scientist, it's your combination of technical and soft skills that will set you apart from the crowd. For me, there are some soft skills that I value particularly. Firstly, having a positive attitude. It's important to get beyond defining the problem and start looking for the solutions. As a chief executive, I don't have time to focus on the negative. I'm looking for people to offer me answers and to describe a path forward. Heraclitus said that the only thing that is constant is change. And I can attest to this. One of the skills I learned early in my career has been surviving through change. It's a skill I've applied on many occasions and one that has proven invaluable. Good communication skills are crucial, transmitting and receiving. I repeatedly hear that the biggest barrier to getting science at the heart of government is poor communication. I encourage you to learn how to convey your messages in a way that your audience is ready and able to hear, and be open to listening to what they have to say back to you. Working well under pressure, handling the stress that accompanies deadlines and crises, being able to do your best work and deal with ambiguity as you strive to deliver results. My background as a research scientist turned policymaker has given me ample opportunity to demonstrate and grow these skills. It's also strengthened my belief that science is critical for good decision making. While some might suggest that I'm a poacher turned gamekeeper, and they certainly did when I joined the Ministry of Research, Science and Technology, I can tell you, I prefer to think of it as being on covert operations. I'm committed to ensuring that the policy my agency develops has a strong evidence base and is well supported by science. As you move forward with your careers and consider what your next steps might be, I'd encourage you to remember three key things. Firstly, your skills will grow. They are transferable, and to get the most from them, you need to get better at trusting yourself and learning to be bold. Secondly, never lose your desire to learn. Your education so far has given you a lot, but your experiences are yet to give you a whole range of additional skills, in particular those soft skills I mentioned earlier. Finally, for the most important decisions in your life, trust your intuition. Then you can work with everything you have to prove your instincts were right. Throughout my career, I've been a strong believer that you need to have the confidence to back yourself, trusting both your head and your heart, and focusing on what makes you happy. The challenges the world faces today are incredibly complex, but with this complexity comes great opportunity. If we're going to be successful, we'll need to revolutionise how we think about these challenges and how we get to the answers. The challenges will demand a combination of intellect, innovation, and passion. As Mark Twain said, you cannot depend on your mind when your imagination is out of focus. Science and policy will need to work together to seize these new opportunities, and you leave here today with a real opportunity to be there at the forefront of this revolution. My congratulations to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Reynolds, for a most interesting and insightful speech. I ask all of you to join with me in thanking Dr. Reynolds again for his address. This is the meeting of Council in Convocation of the University at which the Pro-Chancellor, Peter Kiley, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Peter Kiley, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within the faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon an Associate Dean of the Faculty of Science, Mrs. Goldstone, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Science. To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Yunyi Gu. Jinghua Guo. Hussein Muhammad Hadi. Maria Maya Hillis. Do Yun Han. Sushi Tanda. Janie Herringer. Laura Michelle Handen. Paul Junior Harris. Muhammad Galif Hassan. Kai Hayakawa. Yung Kung He. Charles Spencer Hild. Jared Mark Healy. Daniel Harrington Hicks. Eunice Lee Ping Hu. Francesca Catherine Higgins. Aaron James Patrick Hill. Cherie Lauren Hill. Sarah Bernadette Hillier. Christopher Ralph Hindmarsh. Navina Kalpana Hera. Alyssa Hayama. Ching Yin Ho. Wing Han Ho. Yi Han Ho. Viet Quoc Hong. Richard John Hoxbergen. Anna Christie Holt. Joshua Allen Homer. Anne Hong. Anne Kong Lee Ying. Bo Go Hao. Jenna Marie Howard. Simon Robert Howard. Vivian Wei Ann Su. Cherry Hu. Chung Long Hu. Emma Kan Hui Hung. Chai Hong Kyung. Peng Xiang Huang. Rolfi Huang. Xiao Qing Huang. Leroy Armstrong Hudson. Toby Shen Ying Hong. Jacques Martin Hunt. Daniel Arthur Hunter. Jared Dean Hunter. Dominic James Hutching. Sophia Madeline Hobbins. Masan Ali Mohammed Ibrahim. Michael Furtau Jr. Aeti. Kyra Shirley Francis Innes Jones. Jessica Emily Ives. Danielle Jacobs. Muhammad Akfan bin Jamaladin. Emerald Carriad Rose James. Sebastian Richard Phillips James. Rowan Llewellyn Jenkins. Katham Ravikant Jagru. Jiangyang Jian. Manjing. Jason Chisuklao Jivivanji. Matthew Ryan Jones. Richard Mark Jones. Elizabeth Kate Judd. Namisha Darren Kapadia. Fonti Sukming Kar. Melissa Liviana Katahadja. Sam Patrick Kavanagh. Justin Richard Keane. Jessica Jan Kinnear. Matthew James Kerno. Chase Sinkor. Ella Hay Kia. Dong Hoan Kim. In Han Kim. Kyun Woo Kim. Taejin Kim. Joshua John Kirkpatrick. Anna Kleinmans. Paul Matthew Kuendas. Jonathan Bart Watko. Sean Ko Young Young. Alan Charles William Costa Smith. Neha Nikita Kumar. Shilpa Cheryl Kumar. Ashnatham Lal. Ai Lam. Shu Chun Lam. Jeffrey David Lang. Thomas Andrew Langford. Sharini Vandana Lata. Winnie Elisa Law. Senior Scholar Science, Rebecca Jane Lawson. Rebecca Jane LeGrice. Terence LeGrove Smith. Nicholas Simon Leake. Christopher Keith Arthur Lear. Shi Min Lee. Timothy Patrick Lee. Yingwei Lee. Kelly Jessica Lee Meyer. Monique Yvette Lees. Emma Louise Lumar. Georgia Nafwai Lenahan Gels. Charmian Ka Mon Leong. Malatino Junior Leota. Senior Scholar Science, Jane Jing Leong. Jun Tu Lee. Lei Lee. Xiao Zhi Lee. Young Lee. Yishan Lee. Yu Young Lee. Xi Chao Lee. Nai Xin Liang. Zoe Rhiannon Lightfoot. Dong Hyun Lim. Tessa Yi Huen Lim. Lin Lin. Yanji Lin. Anyang Lu. Ricky Ken Lun Liu. Yabo Lu. Katrina Sarah Tan Levisich. Hey Min Lo. Nicholas John Lowther. Chom Ma. Ma Go Ping. Wen Ying Crystal Ma. Yan Ma. Tara Catherine McKenzie. Joanna Lorraine McKissick. Joel Lucas McMahon. Justin Liam Madrigal. Stephanie Elizabeth McGee. Shabnam Mahbub. Haishan May. Jenny May. Emma Mary Malcolm. Mugda Manda. Nicholas Simon Maher. Naomi Martin Blanche. Michelle Louise Matthews. Patrick Joseph McCathery. Kushla Rose McCartney. Amy Jane McCowie Chapman. Lucy Jane McDowell Hook. Sam Francisco Sellers McGarvey. Scott Daniel McGowan. Cassandra Leslie McGregor. Michael David McKenzie. George Spencer McMahon. Alexandra Che Melville. Laura Elizabeth Melville-Evans. Fancy Ming. Tegan Natalie Metcalf. Roll Yu Mao. Lauren May Miller. Senior Scholar Nurul Adabar Mohammed Rashid. Nurhaswan Mohammed Zain. Hazel Susan Monkman. Philip Pil Kyung Moon. Thomas Charles Morrison. Cheyenne Maria Antonia Muller. Oliver James Munro. Thomas Peter Murgatroyd. Janine Maurice Naidu. Sian Carmel Naidu. Monisha Kamani Naidu. Mustafa Abdullah Saylor Naji. Natalie Narita Nand. Apoorv Narang. Eleanor Christie Natras. Yvonne Hugh Wen Ng. Winnie Ng. Sir Xiang Nu. Nguyen Ho Nia. Dylan John Nixon. Norliana Nussman. Chloe Elizabeth Mary O'Shea. Cameron Rex Ottaway. Sam Nang O. Molly Kamodney Palaniapan. Shannon Palmer. Alice Yang Mu Pang. Deborah Park. Jun Park. Preet Kamal Pamar. Yeah! Hertha Muskin Parvis. Priyanka Patel. Shreya Narendra Patel. Mihailo Pavlovich. Stephanie Ann Pete. Nina Avetmova Peshava. Lilith Leaping. Dale Christian Avila Peralta. Sam Ethan Perkins. Anna Prochaska. Alexandra Mary Pittaway. Sonia Maria Polak. Diksha Dipal Prasad. Jaya Davina Prasad. Sonal Pravita. Lauren Pryor. Joshua John Charles Pritchard. Anna Frances Probert. Otto Prodan. Sushila Marie Lagopura. Guanyang Shi. Ang Xiao. Shanna Ting Yong Kwik. Jonathan Russell Rankin. Keshne Narao Rasana Yagam. Nisala Thikshana Ratanaki. Spencer Magnus Arthur Charles Raymond. Haley Danielle Lieber. Zena Breda. Kenneth Lawson Ridley. Lena Hanella Riccola.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Kalauni Povalu, accompanied by Wan Kim, will now perform O Van de Sept La Tristesse from the operet Hamlet by Ambrose Thomas.
Les plus sages sont les fous. Mon cœur.
Thank you, Kalani, for that stunning performance. Can I ask you all to join with me in thanking Kalani once again? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Science, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Guildford, to present further graduands in this faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Science, Senior Scholar Science, Stanley McAfee Roche. Callum James Robinson. Jamie Katim Rodriguez. Millie Denise Rout. Stephen Philip Rowland. Ben Leif Rushton. Nur Aguila Ruslan. Aileen Winifred Ryan. Cameron James Ryan. Parikshit Sabawal. Alnez Salih Hisams. Arisha Nushin Samad. Rothbaray Samreeth. Catalina Isabel Sanchez Villegas. Neil Adrian C. Sanchez. Robert Edward Kirk Sori. Claire Helen Scott Knight. Tamina Siddiqui. Hiroki Seiko. Juo Seo. Shivani Sethi. Jin Chang. Anita Crystal Sharma. Ankita Sharma. Melvin Shaw. Robert James Shaw. Lorraine Chen. Ying Wang Shen. Xian Qing. Michael George Sheridan. Luke Nathan Sherwood. Shin Jun Yong. Rachel Ann Chu Smith. Prabhat Lal Shrestha. Matthew Hardy Sillers. Brenda Brenner Silva Sukuria. Holly Sarah Simperingham. Reuben Mark Simpson. Chaitun Bia Singh. Justin Praveen Singh. Kennedy Marie Skelton. Mark Slingsby Jones. Senior Scholar Science, Hannah Marie Smiley. Angela Rowan Smith. Joanne Makatia Janelle Dorothy Smith. Song Dong Ki. Senior Scholar Science, Marisha Source. Jason Grant Spencer. Danielle Jade Stanley. Carly Jade Stanley. Brendan Mark Staveley. Jenny Christina Stephen. Kelly Alexander Stiles. Jack Shran Jie Su. Isbere Subramaniam. Hartan Sun. Ji Hei Sun. Jiang Jun Sun. Yasasi Sundara Paruma. Senol Pranal Sushil. Senior Scholar Science, Joel Matthew Sutton. Ethan Tamler. Jeffrey Sutanto Tang. Sombath Tang. Noor Mohammed Tawfiq. Sarah Tawfiq. Danielle Marie Tahern. Vivian Rosette Malapit Tesoro. Grace Chrissy Tedley. Briar Alana Titchens. Bernadette Marie Tippett. Norman Ikiroma Tirumalu. Peter Andrew Tizard. Cherie Tania Tolimash. Alyssa Mary Top. Lindsay Rose Evelyn Top. Gillian G. Ying Tran. Phuc Thien Vu Tran. Donald Tong Day Say. Ashley Francis Tuck. Canthorn Tup Monoko. Deb Mary Tutty. Tofua I Pangai Kamoto Tui Fiafi. Scott Twynham. Heidi Van Wick. Matias Jose Tixara Vargas. Rohit Alphonsus Irwin Victor. Olga Vilk. Yuktibin Vas. Holly Victoria Wade. Senior Scholar Science, Samantha Courtney Rose Wakefield. Senior Scholar Science, Michael Alden Walden. Stephen Lachlan Wallace. Kieran Alex Wormsley. Abby Juliet Barbara Walsh. Ching Ching Wang. Dia Wang. Yufang Wang. Aruni Sachi Guyana Wanagasakara. Jessica Monique Ward. Benjamin Amand Wensley Warren. Rebecca Ann Waters. Sophie Alexandra Waters. Jeremy Jones Watson. Nicholas Roy Owen Watts Henwood. Grace Tun Chia Wei. Wei Si Wei. Song Chen Samson Wing. Rachel Marie Tulia West. Rebecca Stephanie Westcott. Simon Keith Whelan. Christopher Leslie White. Reuben Murray White. Sophia Beverly Veronica White. T.G. Danusha Wadathra Widjarathana. Muthu Pavani Wijawathana. Bianca Rose Wildish. Heidi Esther Williams. Jonathan Joel Williams. Sean Logan Reed Williamson. Jonathan Jaipal Wilson. Elizabeth Amelia Wintentong. Olivia Margaret Winton. Grace Elizabeth Lang Volonsevich. Justin Wong. Kaiyun Wong. Linda Sukwa Wong. Edward Leonard Wong Tzu. Georgina Iris Wood. James Michael Wood. Jonathan Simon Thomas Woodhead. Danielle Marie Woolley. Rewa Palliser Worley. Xian Qion Wu. Landy Mu Chewu. Ming Wu. Hao Ji Alan Ji. Xiaohui Zhu. Matthew James Yates. Christy Yee. Monica Wei Waiyi. Jiao Ye. Li Li Yong. Victor Victor Yim. Hei Sung Yu. Ji Yun Yu. Joan Jae Won Yun. Peter Yu. Rezan Yusuf. Yung Sik Yun. David Kevin, Kevin Zarodini. Nina Zing. Zhang Jinkang. Yu Qian Zhao. Hana Zhu. Postgrad Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with Merit. Bo Yun. Postgraduate Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise, Tony Zeli. Jun Tian Liu. Bo Yu. to the degree of Master of Bioscience Enterprise with first class honours. Vasishta Baji Antia. Tamsin Heria Simpson Bateman. Kim Hong Dang. Alexander William Franklin Smith. Michael Derek Fassil. Laura Elizabeth Haycock and a postgrad diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with merit. Sujit Kalidas. Veena Widjapaskar Kormari. Harriet McIntosh Sandstad. Mervyn Solistio, and a Bachelor of Science and a Postgrad Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with merit. To the degree of Master of Bioscience Enterprise with Second Class Honours, First Division, Avantika Gupta, and a Postgrad Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with distinction. Michael Blair Sullivan, and a Postgrad Diploma in Bioscience Enterprise with merit. Tony Ming Long Wei. To the degree of Master of Science with First Class Honours, Nazneen Adanwala in Biomedical Science. Marie Norbert in Environmental Science. Tianyang Chu in Statistics. Carl Mote Crosby in Biological Sciences. University Graduate Scholar Sean Neil Curry in Mathematics. Natalie Janet Delorme-Urey in Marine Science. Mandana Godratapur in Biomedical Science. Bianca Gordon in Speech Science. Jesse John Edward Hart in Mathematics. University Graduate Scholar Lucy Joan Hallcroft in Environmental Management. Ahab Nihad Mahmoud Jurgis in Biological Sciences. Kun Ju in Computer Science. Bingqing Liu in Computer Science. Max Christian McLean in Geology and a postgraduate diploma in Science with merit in Geology. Young Eun Park in Biomedical Science. Angela Idalina Perks in Geology. Samuel Calvin Ruddell in Physics. University Graduate Scholar Sunkono Sura Tayono in Computer Science. Victoria Gwendolyn Tort in Biological Sciences and a Postgrad Diploma in Science with merit in Biological Sciences. Ralph Bernard Viston in Computer Science and a Bachelor of Science Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division Mathematics and a Bachelor of Science. Jennifer Ann Waite in Biosecurity and Conservation. Sandra Yunar Wilson in Wine Science. To the degree of Master of Science with Second Class Honours, First Division, Elizabeth Jane Anderson in Biological Sciences. Linko in Psychology. Well, C in Computer Science. Catherine Laura Davis in Marine Science. Purong Guo in Medical Statistics. Finulan Pather in Biosecurity and a Postgrad Diploma in Science and Biosecurity. Nicholas James Pothikari in Biological Sciences. Kai Wen Singh in Statistics. Jin Jiao in Biological Sciences and a Postgrad Diploma in Science in Biological Sciences. Jin Zhu in Statistics. Yorong Yin in Biomedical Science. Yu Zhao in Statistics. To the degree of Master of Science with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Ind Biava in Medical Statistics. And Anandita Devi in Biomedical Science. Lloyd Joseph Franks in Environmental Management. Wesley Thomas Johnson in Environmental Management. Meena Kumari in Mathematics. Manpreet Singh Mala in Bioinformatics. Simon Alexander Metcalf in Chemistry. Nokmin Tan Yuan in Biological Sciences and a Postgrad Diploma in Science and Biological Sciences. Angela Joyce Malu Pirua, Pirinisi Doreen Tagaloa in Biological Sciences. Tumvi Isabella Vudok in Environmental Management. Alistair Murray Young in Geography. To the degree of Master of Science, Nicholas Kirkus Buckton in Geology. Thomas Allen Harold Lynch in Computer Science. Hannah Jane Thompson in Marine Science and a Postgrad Diploma in Science with Merit in Marine Science. Ning Wong in Environmental Science and a Postgrad Diploma in Science in Environmental Science.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Bhuvaneswari Kannan in Chemistry, University Doctoral Scholar. Bhuvaneswari fabricated a novel miniaturised DNA sensing tool based on conducting polymers with the aim of developing a new generation of commercially useful electrical and electrochemical DNA sensors for rapid detection of genetic diseases. Bhuvaneswari. Yunbun Kim in Computer Science. Yun designed bio-inspired computing models to investigate several fundamental distributed algorithms with a view to obtaining effective solutions beyond the reach of conventional computing methods. Cheryl Rebecca Kroll in Biological Sciences, University Doctoral Scholar. Cheryl investigated the extent of feral pig disturbance in the Waitakere Ranges and quantified the impacts of this disturbance on key ecosystem processes. Her research outcomes included the development of pig management strategies for Auckland Council that protect ecosystem integrity. Cheryl. Kiribath Godagay Indra Pryor, Ajitalal Kuriratna in Environmental Science. Indra Pryor researched fundamental questions relating to the use of lichens to monitor air pollution. His work demonstrates that certain New Zealand lichens can be effective pollution biomonitors and shows how they can be employed as a complementary method to using expensive, technologically sophisticated monitoring equipment. Natalie Julia Bettina Lorenz in Biomedical Science. Natalie investigated one of the key mechanisms by which the bacterium Staphylococcus aureus escapes the human immune response and establishes an infection. Her characterization of this complex interaction has highlighted potential new strategies for the development of therapies against this multi-drug-resistant bacterium. Philip Robert McGill in Chemistry, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Philip performed computational studies on the absorption of model molecules to crystalline surfaces with a view to improving our understanding of the reactions behind catalysts. Jovine Kai-Ting-Ing in Food Science. Jovine investigated the cell wall properties of apples to understand why the apple variety Jazz can be kept for longer without losing its firm, crisp texture, while other apple varieties, such as Royal Gala, tend to soften. Apples with superior texture are preferred by consumers and fetch a higher commercial value. Yiwen Pei in Chemistry. Yiwen demonstrated new methods for electrically switching the wettability of polymer surfaces. These methods could have significant applications, especially for control of fluid flow in microfluid and lab-on-a-chip technologies. Mawish Riaz in Computer Science. Mawish investigated the factors and prediction techniques that can be employed successfully to predict the maintainability of relational database-driven applications with a view to reducing software maintenance costs. She found that case-based reasoning and classification and regression trees are successful techniques for predicting maintainability of relational database-driven applications. Susan Richter in Biomedical Science. Susan investigated the function of a novel human enzyme, ADP-dependent glucokinase, so helping to improve our understanding of glucose metabolism in cancer cells. Mohammed Suleiman in Computer Science. Mohammed investigated factors that can be successfully employed to introduce and enhance software process improvement within small and medium web companies. He developed a theoretical framework of these success factors suitable for use by organizations to help them increase the likelihood of organizational success. Emma Joanna Tacken in Biological Sciences. Emma investigated the transcriptional regulation of softening during commercial apple fruit ripening in a study conducted in collaboration with the New Zealand Institute for Plant and Food Research. Peter Charles Robert Wilberforce in Biological Sciences. University doctoral scholar. Peter investigated morphological and physiological cold adaptation in Polynesian populations and compared these to other human populations. He showed that Polynesians exhibit cold-adapted body morphology and strong physiological resistance to cold, suggesting that these are evolutionary adaptations to cold ancestral climates in Northeast Asia. To the degree of Doctor of Science, Michelle Kelly. Michelle researched the taxonomy, systematics, and phylogenetics of sponges. She also made major contributions in fields such as regional biodiversity, chemical oceanography, aquaculture, and marine natural products chemistry. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Science.
We are now nearing the conclusion of this graduation ceremony. So on behalf of the university, I invite all of today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And while you are standing, this would be a great opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of Council in Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme.